Today, I'm going to introduce you guys to Project Titan, a massive dual system build, fully water cooled with NVIDIA Titan graphics cards. So let's get ready and let's see how it came out. Hey guys, Tiago with Classical Technology here. Thank you for joining me for another video. In today's video, we're going to be looking at the Project Titan build that I did. Now, this is an awesome two-system build, fully water-cooled. That means we have an ATX system at the top with a Titan XP graphics card, and on the bottom, we have a mini ITX system, also with a Titan X, but this is the Maxwell version, the little bit older card. Everything is running on the same loop. You can see we have this massive reservoir. We have all these things going on, and we're using the Fantex Revolt X dual system power supply in order to make this happen. And of course, this is the Fantex Lux 2 case, or they've recently changed the name of it to the 719. It's the case formerly known as the Lux 2. But anyway, this is a massive case, full of water cooling support. I fit a 480 EK XE radiator on the front, an EK 360 degrees performance edition radiator at the top with a whole lot of very quiet fans. I'm using the Be Quiet Silent Wings 3 fans. They keep everything nice and cool and the noise profile is really good. And I have, of course, a D5 pump circulating the liquid throughout the entire loop. And the coolant that I'm using is the EK opaque yellow coolant, which I think looks really nice in person and gives this build a nice subtle look. I tried not to go too crazy with RGB. I just have basically these yellow subtle lights. So usually with a big water cooling build like this, what I like to do is first build in the system not water cooled. That means use air cooling, use maybe an AIO. That way I just test the components, make sure nothing's bad. Especially I have a couple of things here that are new that I've never used before. That way you can catch if you have bad RAM or maybe a bad graphics card. It's not always feasible to do this, especially if you're in a time crunch, but I actually like doing it anytime I have a little bit more time, because then you get to really kind of learn the case as you're building a regular build in it. You've had a little bit of time to think on maybe different tubing patterns or maybe think of what you want to do as you learn the strengths and limitations of the case. So I did just that with this case. So let's take a look how this case went from empty to an air-cooled build to a fully water-cooled dual system build. So I'm going to take you through it. All right, guys, thank you very much for watching. I want to thank all my subscribers as well. Very happy to see you guys here. The channel is growing nicely, and I'm going to have more content. Remember, every Tuesday and Friday, we have a new video, and every Monday, we have tech news. So thank you again. Like if you enjoyed the video. Leave a comment if you have any questions. And please remember to subscribe, and I'll catch you on the next video.